Now, people all over the world are dealing with what life throws at them. And here in the UK, we've seen the devastation that has hit Ukraine during the war. Sadly, millions of families have been forced to flee their homes to try and escape.
Yeah, many of them have found safety in the UK. Nikita has been to meet some of the refugees finding their feet in Greater Manchester with the help and generosity of the local community.
The winner of the Eurovision Song Contest 2022 is Ukraine!
Winning Eurovision was a really proud moment for me and my country. But sadly, it came with the backdrop of the horrible scenes from the war back at home.
It breaks my heart watching what is happening in Ukraine. It's a war that is affecting everyone, including my close family and friends.
But what's incredibly reassuring is the help those living in Ukraine have been receiving here in the UK. Since last March, the Homes for Ukraine scheme has found accommodation for more than 100,000 people in host homes around the country. But now, over a year into the scheme, many of those guests need to find new hosts or even better, a home of their own. And people like retired estate agent Stephen Goodison are stepping up to help.
My wife and myself decided we could probably do something to help the Ukrainians. Mm-hmm. We've been involved in property all our working life, and we've also done quite a bit of fundraising over the years. So we felt we put those two things together, we could provide homes where we'd pay maybe the first year's rent up front. Mm-hmm. We would provide brand new bedding, brand new beds and mattresses and wardrobes and kits.
Based in Staleybridge, near Manchester, Stephen and his wife's project is being funded by the local community.
We started off thinking, yeah, maybe raise 10,000, and we've had donations, 50 pence, up to £6,000. One particular person said, hey, I've got a property, you can have it free for a year. So we've had some really, really generous people. We've raised in the region of £260,000, and I think we're on 27, maybe 28 families.
That's incredible. How does it make you feel that you could help so many families?
It's incredible. We can't believe it. This picture was drawn by Sophia. She's the 5-year-old girl. This was my Christmas present off her, which she drew. And to me, that's worth everything we've done twice over, because it means a lot. And that's something I will treasure forever.
I've come to the local Ukrainian club in Staleybridge to meet this young artist and her mother, Dina.
Yeah, I very appreciate for Stephen to live in a separate house, just I and my daughter. And it's all just with help, Stephen. Without his help, I don't know.
What were the difficulties of coming with Sophia all the way from Ukraine to the UK?
The biggest challenge was to decide that I should leave my country in the war, and all my family stayed there. It was the hardest for me. It was a very difficult decision.
But you did it for Sophia.
Yes, yes. And I'm happy that I did it, because she is in safe place, mm-hmm. and she doesn't hear sirens. It's very scary for a little child to hear sirens.
The Atamaninenko family also had to make the same decision. Natalia, Maxim, 5-year-old Nikki and 4-year-old Artyom are excited to see their new home for the first time.
Wow. This is incredible.
Natalia and her family have just got the keys to a place they can call home, a year after fleeing from their hometown, Odessa.
We already started to move in together, and I guess you will move in completely then later on with the kids.
Yeah, they're so excited.
You had such a long journey. You moved from Moldova, Romania, Spain, all the way up to the UK. How did the kids react to all of this?
I think, yeah, really difficult for them, for both of them, because they're too small and their brain, they can't understand what's going on now. Hopefully it'll be easier next few months, but in the past, yeah, honestly, we lost our friends, our lifestyle, close family, so it's really difficult.
Odessa was sadly heavily shelled in April 2022, by which point Natalia and her family had already made it to the UK and were living with the host family. But after 8 months, their placement was coming to an end, and that's when they met Stephen.
He said, let's go with me.
I'll help you.
I'll help you, yeah, to find some solution with your own accommodations. And sometimes, you know, I'm worried about, it's so great to be true. Mm-hmm. But it's true mm-hmm. now, because we are in our own accommodation.
Back at the Ukrainian club, I'm keen to meet with some of the regulars who have also been helped by Stephen. The growing Ukrainian community have started to feel a real sense of belonging.
Сейчас, как вас зовут?
Anna.
Anna, which feeling does this place give you?
It's feeling like home. All people from Ukraine here, we can speak on our language, or it's very comfortable here.
It's like a free place. When you come and feeling freedom. And I'm very happy to see people who comes from Ukraine. Mm-hmm. Because we like a little family here.
Mm-hmm. What does it mean to you, what Stephen could do for you?
I'm with my boys here. I have two sons. And if he didn't help us, I don't know what we will do next. Because it's hard.
To see so many families making new homes is really heartwarming. And best of all, just an hour down the road in Liverpool, this year's Eurovision Song Contest will be championing all things Ukrainian. And some of the biggest cheers will come from behind these doors.
The war may still be going on, but places like this show us that nothing can break the amazing spirit of Ukrainian people. And whilst there is a lot wrong in the world, people like Stephen show that there is an awful lot right in it too. Well done!
It is so heartwarming to see those Ukrainian families making a life here and doing so well. Thanks so much for doing that film, Nikita. It was brilliant to see those families. Really, really good stuff. And actually, connecting with others is so important, no matter where.